Bitcoin finally at the all-time high, radio silence from the SEC regarding the Ethereum ETF, and record numbers when it comes to daily active users on Solana. That and more in the Crypto Talk this week. This week we will talk about Bitcoin. It finally crossed the all-time high as I've expected it last week, but we will talk about kind of the implications and what's going on right now. Then we'll talk about Ethereum, specifically on one side the Ethereum ETF, and on the other side the potential hard fork that's actually coming up this week called Denken. Then at the end we'll talk about Solana and some deals that's going on in the Solana ecosystem and what it means for the price. Let's jump right in, and we're seeing following headline: Bitcoin surges after crypto ETPs notch a record $2.7 billion in weekly inflows. And we're of course referring to the CoinShares report here, and this specific number, $2.7 billion, have come into the crypto assets in at the exchange traded products. So it's not just the ETFs, but just generally crypto products. Although we have to say specifically, 2.6 billion of the 2.7 came to Bitcoin. So it was specifically Bitcoin products that have gotten the majority of these $2.7 billion. And it actually brings the year-to-date numbers up until $10.3 billion. Now you might think this is actually not that high, but compare it to 2021, and the total of all inflows in 2021 was actually $10.6 billion. So very likely that next week or this week we will already cross the $10.6 billion mark. Now of course we will have to see in what effect this will have for the Bitcoin price specifically. We've seen Bitcoin cross the all-time high, and currently it's going quite well. It's also going quite well for El Salvador. Their Bitcoin treasury is now $85 million in profit, and because of the Bitcoin rally, they're sitting on around $200 million worth of Bitcoin. Now, a lot of people have made jokes about El Salvador because their average purchase price was around $46,000, and then of course afterwards the Bitcoin price has dropped down to up until $16,000, and since then has risen back up to an all-time high of $72,000. Now currently we're very close to the 72 once again. Of course my area of interest here has broken fundamentally, but we can see here actually it has came really pretty much into this range, then dropped back down, tried the range once again, and then actually all-time high was crossed. And now of course if we kind of zoom out a bit more and think about what is essentially next, we can see very clearly usually when an all-time high gets broken, mania breaks out, and we will see kind of this price discovery area that we've seen in 2021. We've had this first price discovery, then the price came back down, then we've reached a proper all-time high since then, and then of course the bear market started. Again, accumulation phase here, we dropped out of the accumulation phase, and now we're in this really, really interesting spot here where Bitcoin is essentially in price discovery mode. Currently looking at the inflows from the ETFs, it is very clear that the demand is fairly high still. Now, how is it looking on the Ethereum side? Unfortunately, we're having radio silence from the SEC side regarding an Ethereum ETF, and that is usually not a good sign. At least that's what the Bloomberg analysts are saying. They're even saying that they are expecting a 35% chance that the Ethereum ETF is getting through end of May. So it isn't zero, of course, but it looks way less likely than, let's say, 2 months ago. However, this could be kind of multiple faceted, because a lot of people are also saying, why would the SEC approve an Ethereum futures product in autumn, but then would opt against the spot ETF product, which is very similar to the Bitcoin spot ETF. In my opinion, the only reason why the ETF might be delayed or postponed or completely kind of off the table would be if Ethereum is deemed a security by the SEC due to the staking mechanism. We remember about a month ago, we've seen some of the ETF managers bring additional details in where they would want to stake the Ethereums that they've gotten from the spot ETF inflows. So it could very well be that this is kind of the major problem for the SEC. However, in the Ethereum ecosystem, interesting things are happening, specifically this hard fork that is coming in the coming days. We're of course talking about the Denken upgrade, which will be probably out when you're seeing this episode, if all goes well. That will mean also that the L2 technology, so the layer 2 on top of Ethereum, will be way cheaper. We're talking hundreds of times cheaper than the current transaction cost. So this is a great, great development. Another great thing about blockchain technology in general is the programmability of money. So essentially, Vitalik Buterin here is even saying a development that would start today on Ethereum, they could even subvert a quantum attack. Now, what is a quantum attack? Quantum computing is essentially said to be released in the coming years, and quantum computing would make the typical cryptography rules completely obsolete. And that would, of course, mean essential problems that we will have, not only on the crypto side, by the way, also for banking and how we store passwords and so on and so forth. But for now, quantum computing is still far out, and it does look like Ethereum is actually very well positioned to actually subvert a quantum attack, according to Vitalik Buterin. Now, if we look at the chart, we can see the following here. Excellent range has hit, as I've mentioned here. The 4,000 US dollar line has been hit, and now we're kind of ranging in that area. And then, of course, next up will be the interesting area of around 4,800. That will be Ethereum's all-time high, and I expect full-blown mania after this step. However, currently, we're still sitting at around 4,000 US dollars, and it's probably gonna consolidate here for a few more days or weeks before we attempt at least to go a bit higher. I mean, we could potentially also see a small drop off here at around 4,500 US dollars before we actually reach these other lines. Now we can clean up the chart a bit more, and we can see already here exponential growth on Ethereum side since October. So this is already again in mania mode. What is also very positive is the development on Solana, because we're seeing all-time high in daily new addresses. Specifically, the blocks dashboard is showing here that the number of new addresses on the Solana network, that is daily and a daily moving average, is currently sitting at around 700,000, even 691,000 to 700,000 daily active numbers. And that actually shows that the activity on Solana is increasing. Now, of course, on Solana, because Solana's transaction costs are very low and it is very, very fast to essentially transact on the network. Another really interesting thing here, Pantera is raising funds to buy Solana holding from FTX. So what Pantera is currently doing is offering to buy Solana tokens for around 55 to 60 US dollars, and currently the Solana price is sitting at around 150, to buy the remaining Solana tokens, around 41 million, from FTX or their estate. So there are already in chapter 11 bankruptcy, and these Solana tokens are being auctioned off, and Pantera will try to get those. And Pantera is also saying, if you buy tokens from us for around 60 US dollar per one Solana token, you have to have a 4-year vesting period. So if you want to do that, an OTC trade, that is a potential, but you have to have a minimum amount of around 250,000 US dollars to get actually in the Solana action. Currently, again, the Solana price sits at around $150. Again, very interesting trade here. According to Fibonacci, we should hit 157. We haven't exactly hit that number yet, but I'm thinking we're getting very, very close here. So I'm expecting this to get hit and then broken once again. And afterwards, this should become very interesting. That was it from the Crypto Market Talk this week. Make sure that you're subscribed also on the audio for the podcast, and I will see you on the next one. Have a good one. We'll be right back.